Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of the Father, and the unity of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Welcome. So delighted to be together with all of you to celebrate today the great saints in heaven. Let us call to mind our sins and failings and ask for God's mercy.
You are sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who chose the Bishop of St. Patrick, preacher of glory for the peoples of Ireland, grant through his merits and intercession, that those who glory in the name of a Christian may never cease to proclaim your wondrous deeds to all. Who our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let's be seated to listen to God's word.
Reading from the book of Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, in a time of favor I answer you, and on the day of salvation I help you, and I have kept you and given you as a covenant to the people, to restore the land and allot the desolate heritages, saying to the prisoners, come out. To those in darkness, show yourselves. Along the ways, they shall find pasture. On every bare height shall their pastures be. They shall not hunger or thirst, nor shall the scorching wind or the sun strike. For he beside springs of water. I will cut a road to all my mountains and make my highways level. See, some shall come from afar, others from the north and the west, and some from the land of Zion. Sing out, O heaven, and rejoice, O earth. Bring forth into song your mountains, for the Lord comforts his people and shows mercy to his afflicted. But Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me. My Lord has forgotten me. Can a mother forget her infant? Be without tenderness for the child of her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you. The word of the Lord.
Amen.
Our responsorial song is, the Lord is gracious and merciful.
Because he
not only broke the Sabbath, but he also brought God and his own Father, making himself equal with God. Jesus answered and said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, the Son cannot do anything on his own, but only what he sees the Father do. For what he does, the Son will do also. For the Father loves the Son and shows him everything that he himself does, and he will show him greater works than these, so that you may be amazed. For just as the Father raises the dead and gives life, so also does the Son give life to whomever he wishes. Nor does the Father judge anyone, but he has given all judgment to the Son, so that all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but has passed from death to life. Amen, amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to the Son the possession of life in himself. And he gave him power to exercise judgment because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and will come out, those who have done good deeds in the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. I cannot do anything by my own. I judge as I hear, and my judgment is just, because I do not seek my own will, but the will of the one who sent me." Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
That means Saint Patrick's Day to everyone. Saint Patrick of Ireland was born in Roman Britain. He was 14 or so. He was captured by Irish pirates during a raiding party and taken to Ireland as a slave to herd and tend sheep. At the time, Ireland was a land of druids and pagans. Patrick turned to God and wrote in his memoir, "The love of God and his fear grew in me more and more, as did the faith. My soul was ruled, so that in a single day I had said as many as 100 prayers, and in the night nearly had said nearly the same. I prayed in the woods and on the mountain, even before dawn. I felt no hurt from the snow or the ice or the rain." Patrick's captivity lasted until he was 20. He escaped after having a dream from God in which he was told to leave Ireland by going to the coast. There he found some sailors who took him back to Britain, and he was reunited with his family. A few years after returning home, Patrick saw a vision he described in his memoir. "I saw a man coming, as it were, from Ireland. His name was Victoricus, and he carried many letters. He gave me one of them. I read the heading, 'The Voice of the Irish.' As I began the letter, I imagined in that moment that I heard the voice of those very people who were near the wood of Fulcland, which is beside the Western Sea. And they cried out as with one voice, 'We appeal to you, holy servant boy, to come back and walk among us.' The vision prompted his studies for the priesthood. He was ordained by Saint Germanus, the bishop of Auxerre, under whom he had studied for years, and later ordained a bishop and was sent for the sake of the gospel to Ireland. There are several legends about what happened next, which are the most prominent, claiming that he met the chieftain of one of those druid tribes who tried to kill Patrick. After an intervention from God, Patrick was able to convert the chieftain and preach the gospel throughout all of Ireland. There he converted many people, eventually thousands, and began building churches across the country. Patrick preached and converted all of Ireland over 40 years. He was known to have worked many miracles, some of which are kind of questionable, but he was known for the many. But he was able to preach so powerfully, as I say, those miracles, and he wrote of his love for God in his confession. After years of living in poverty, traveling, and enduring much suffering, he died in 461 on this day, the 17th of March. St. Patrick changed Ireland forever. Not only did he convert Ireland, his influence was universal. With his work, religious orders and monasteries were established and spread, and these orders preserved the faith during a period often kind of sadly referred to as the Dark Ages. His work continued for many centuries, in fact, it continues now. As the Irish emigrated, they took their faith with them all over the world. The eyes of the church, his sanctity, isn't about the marvelous accomplishments of his life, but about the actual living of his Catholic faith. He was a saint. In other words, he lived the gospel and loved Christ above all things. This is what makes his life exemplary. How appropriate, then, that we hear Isaiah declare that this is the day of salvation, that God has given Patrick to the people of Ireland and to the world to restore the land, to allot the desolate heritages, to free prisoners, to enlighten those in darkness, and to shepherd the people after the example of Jesus, the Good Shepherd. And so today, with all God's children, particularly with the people of Ireland and her children in the worldwide diaspora, we can sing and cry out for joy and the mercy God has shown us all, and particularly the beautiful. Because God, who is kind and merciful, never forsakes his beloved children. A mother would forget her baby before God and forgot any one of us. The genius and the love of Patrick was because of his clear focus on the love of Jesus Christ and his passion to share that love and faith with people whom he came to love as his own. Patrick saw himself in Jesus, the Son of our Father God. So what he does and what Patrick does are a clear and sure view of how God works. For all these centuries, human minds are in awe of what great things the Lord our God accomplishes. The life of Christ and that of St. Patrick give us the same message. Get rid of those false ideas, that false image of God as a judge of our daily lives. Instead, come to know the Father through the love we experience in the Son. So to the Universal Church, we say today, praise be our Lord and his saints. May God bless us all and give us the wisdom to take the example of Jesus and of Patrick, be true daughters and sons of so loving a Father, sharing God's goodness, kindness, and justice with real people, those we meet daily, so that they too might give glory and praise to the God who loves them and us forever. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us offer our prayer for the Lord.
Our
response is more than appropriate. For Pope Francis, our Holy Father, may God bless him with strength and courage as he continues to embrace the office of the Vicar of Christ on earth. We pray to may the faith of St. Patrick brought to Ireland continue to guide Ireland and all nations. We pray to the
Lord.
For mutual respect of all people, for an end to terrorism and violence around. for continued peace in Northern Ireland, we pray to the Lord. For peace, justice, and aid for victims of persecution, poverty, disease, homelessness, natural disasters, and famine around the world, we pray to the Lord. For all those affected by the pandemic, the freeze, and other difficulties, we pray to the
Lord.
For the alumni, friends, and benefactors of the University of St. Thomas and the William J. Flynn Center for Higher Studies, the university students, faculty, and staff, and all those present today, in person or virtually, we pray to the
Lord.
For our friends and members of our families who have passed before us, let them rest in peace. We pray to the
Lord.
For the special intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the
Lord.
Place into your loving hands, O Father, all of your people, all of the nations, and our prayers, hopes, and needs. Take them all to your heart, and give us those things that we truly need, as we pray in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Safe and answered in his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, sing the hymn of your praise is without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, Lord, we pray, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, and his fathers, and the lips and apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we be co-heirs to eternal life. May we pray and glorify the Son of Jesus.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our
Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And let us offer each other peace.
Thank you.
By the power of this mystery, O Lord, confirm your servants in the true faith, that they may everywhere profess and word in thee the faith which was intended and never cease to labor, and for which he spent his whole life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. If you know this moment, you can be seated.
May the protection of Christ clothe you, and Christ unfold you, surrounding you and guarding you this day and every day, surrounding you and your companions, enfolding you and every friend. May God and the angels guard us. May God bring us home rejoicing. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. The Mass has ended. Glory be to the Lord.
Thanks be to God.